first and foremost, why did that concrete and metal give way and leave more than a dozen workers injured on the job site?
Now, here is a live look for you at the scene right now. State inspectors are already on the scene to begin the investigation. You can see the picture right behind me here. Construction workers were sent home this morning right after this accident. We have live team coverage tonight from every angle for you, beginning with News 5's John London. John?
Well, 10 hours into the investigation, Sheree, how soon casino construction site activity can pick up again as you take a live look here from street level at the site. OSHA won't allow it to reopen until it deems it safe to do so. Take a closer look now at the area where this morning's collapse occurred. It is a 60 by 60 foot section on the southern side of the 20-acre casino site. It was here, as workers poured concrete, that a beam supporting the second floor of the casino structure gave way, sending several workers sliding along with rebar and materials into the midsection of a V collapse. And it brought an abrupt halt to the building of a $400 million project.
Well, obviously the situation is not what we want to see on a construction site in Cincinnati.
OSHA has at least two investigators on site tonight, might bring in more depending on need. A state investigator arrived shortly after the collapse, which is unexplained so far. We're told every possibility will be examined. What each of the workers was doing at the time, what safety precautions were in place, were the wet, muddy conditions a factor? Rock, Ohio was also asked if there's any similarity to the December 16th garage collapse in Cleveland, where the same developer is building.
These are two different construction management companies, two different contractors, two different sites, two different areas. It is absolutely nothing in common with the two different sites.
The safety record here has been good. The contractors had been allowed to monitor their own safety procedures without any constant OSHA oversight. Tonight, there is relief that no injury from the accident is serious. Collective recognition that the investigation carries serious weight, enough to stop all work here, waiting for OSHA's clearance that it's safe to resume.
We're making sure that the scene's secured and it's going to be closed down until that time.
And when that time will be is unclear, so is whether portions of the site that you're looking at live here now can reopen while the investigation proceeds. We've not been told what workers have been told about whether they should show up for any of their schedules over the next few days, but we have been told that nothing can resume here until OSHA says it is safe to come back. Reporting live at the casino construction site, John London, News 5.